system free.
So, for the very last talk of this evening, after learning how to break into intercoms, we're going to learn a huge number of ways in which you can break into ATMs. We got here Olga and Alexey. They are part of the penetration testing team at Kaspersky Lab, and they will tell us more about this. Thank you.
So most of you use bank cards to buy something in shops and malls and other places, but sometimes you need cash. For example, when you go to the lounge and want to buy some chunk, and you need to go to ATM, and you look around and search for skimmers, for hidden cameras, for some fake PIN pads or some other stuff from bad guys. And if is everything okay, you will insert your bank card into ATM, enter your PIN, enter amount of money, and what you can see. ATM say that there is no money for a long time. From bank side, it is this ATM is full of money. That's because some lucky hacker, maybe right now, eject all money from this ATM. And if he was really lucky, he obtained quarter million euros, and that's because ATM, this ATM, is not ideal. So today we would like to tell you about ideal situation when ATM is secure with several level of protection. And time to say hello. I'm Olga Kochetova, and he is my colleague Alexey Osipov. We are from Kaspersky Lab. We get our knowledge from ATM and post security assessment, penetration testing, forensic investigation, and other funny activities. But first of all, let me give you several words about ATM in general, just for your understanding. You might be familiar with various types of ATMs, for example, cash-in or cash-out ATMs, or even recycling systems. It might be standalone ATMs or through-the-wall ATMs, but it should be noticed that there are several ATM vendors around the world. They just take small parts, small hardware units produced by various manufacturers, and put it together into the box and call it ATM. So it's just a Lego for big vendors, for big men. So the top box of ATM called service zone or cabinet. There are PC, just usual PC, card reader, pin pad, and so on. The bottom box of ATM called safe. There are some financial devices, such as dispenser to eject money, or note acceptor to insert money, and so on. All hardware units connected to PC through serial or USB ports. The main software is a Microsoft Windows-based operating system, and the most case when ATM run on Windows XP. Despite the fact that Microsoft stopped to support this operating system almost 3 years ago. There are also main ATM software, which provide graphic user interface to interact with customers or with service engineers. Other part of this software is a piece of software to communicate with processing center, to interact with bank networks. And the last one part is device control systems. There are also some security software, such as antiviruses, integrity control systems, or video surveillance. But there are also, and often, some very crappy software and very needless software. And sometimes this software gives attacker unlimited control to this ATM. What about devices? Devices are unclear. There are some strange microcontrollers with real-time operating system, and usually guys who laugh at the pro very sad about it. On the slide, you can see a small schema of ATM, and it is not complex and very linear. It should be easy to implement secure communication. Generally, no data from hardware units needed inside ATM. And only requested by so-called processing center that make decision to give or not to give money. Other components should just relay data, wrapping it in additional security layers, like onion in Tor networks. To get to data or money, one should uncover all layers or be very near to money. In Wonderland, all ATMs are secure, and let's see how. The lowest level is closest to money and very important to protect. Money contained in the cassettes, and in Wonderland, cassettes are themselves secure. No one can get money from them without any special permissions. They are not only physically secure, but also logically secure. If someone will try to eject money, it will be evident and very hard. Nonetheless, if someone will steal the cassettes, it will be easy to trace them. And if someone will try to open the cassette, money will be destroyed. For example, on the slide, you can see money destroyed with hot glue. In extreme case, even if cassettes is open and the money are not destroyed, bank can trace banknotes by different means, for example, by using sequential numbers on the banknotes. And they can be traced like in the movies. And not only cash is the goal for criminals. They also hunt for card data. But in ideal world, card data can't be stolen. There is no static data to be copied. And as for dynamic data, it uses a challenge response schema that protects against relay attacks. And in this case, data cannot be stolen. But it was only in Wonderland, because since bank card contains MAC stripe, it can't be intercepted. And the EMV is not a panacea. Until there are places and even countries that don't use EMV chips, there is always possibility to withdraw money knowing only MAC stripe. Even then, there is possibility for online relay attack. You insert a card in some ATMs, but money is dispensed from another ATMs. As for cassettes, they are not so secure. Most of cassettes have all mechanics to eject nodes outside of cassettes. So it is possible for attackers to get cash by using only screwdriver. And if money was stolen, it is hard to trace them because it is still hard task to mark them and to know where they are used. So let's up to level one. It's a hardware units level. And as I already mentioned, attacker can get €250,000 from each ATM. I think it's enough amount. This amount of money is enough for a couple of chunk for everyone. And a typical dispenser consists of four cash cassettes and one cassette for rejected nodes. There are also many sensors, LEDs, and mechanisms which withdraw money. Some of them eject money from cassettes, other ones present it to the customer, other ones check size of banknotes, and so on. So it looks like firmware should be very complex. The other interesting device is card reader, which used to read MAC stripe and also used to communicate with chip to conduct financial transactions and to check biometric data contained on chip regarding merchant card technologies. This device also should communicate with other units, such as pin pad for offline authentication and biometric devices for biometric authentication. Pin code is used together with card data for client authentication. It is the most secure element because of different standards. PCI, EMV, and other standards provide the bottom line that pin patch should comply to. But not anyone knows that there are two modes of operation, secure and open. Secure mode is used for pin code, and open mode is used for other inputs, for example, when you enter amount of money. Biometric authentication gains popularity because of increased security. There are different kinds of recognition, such as iris, fingerprints, face, and so on. Such features uniquely identify user, so it is considered if they are presented to ATM, such user considered good. Such features can be revoked or changed. Only processing center can send comments to hardware units, and hardware units authenticate with processing center. But sometimes authentication guarantees integrity of comments, but data should be also protected with encryption. In ideal situation, this data is only needed in processing center. Because firmware controls hardware units, it should not be easy modifiable, but it was another lie. Unfortunately, only so-called sensitive comments are authenticated. For example, dispense, but not present if we speak about dispenser. Rumor has it that PinPad encrypts all data that comes from it, but it encrypts only PIN code, but not data. And active man-in-the-middle attack can change one comment with another. Good thing is that PIN codes is encrypted in such a way that data can be decrypted only in processing center. Why it is not done for other hardware units, it's a question, I don't know. As for firmware modification, firmware is often stored on the ATM hard drive as a hex file. And actually, it's not that hard to add some piece of code to existing firmware to create a hidden backdoor. It will react on sequence of the money dispense if you are speaking about dispenser. PCI standards create baseline for card data security, but these standards are not enforced and easily bypassed by banks. Also, there are no such standards for biometric devices, and I think it's strange because you can easily change your PIN code or your bank cards, but you cannot change your iris or your finger. And additionally, there are many systems which use biometric authentication, such as passports, visas, and so on. It means that if you lost the biometric data, you might as well lost your identity. And thank you so much, these guys who built this wall.
Okay, we have spoken about hardware units, but all these hardware units should be somehow connected to the PC computer, to the processing center, and so on. Often, it's just ordinary COM ports or USB devices. But it's often forgotten that USB is also a bus. And there are different researchers that you can easily Google that connect some device to some port of the USB USB hub and obtain all the data that is transmitted over the other lines. And often, banks unfortunately say, OK, we have USB connections. No one ever can sniff this data, transmit it, and so on. But unfortunately, it's not the case. Some older ATMs use so-called SDC bus. It's RS-485 with a common line, and every device on this bus can send comment to another device. And often it is used by malicious guys who understand how it works, and unfortunately, ATM vendors and banks weren't prepared for this situation. These communication lines also should be considered vulnerable and also should be encrypted. And in ideal situation, in Wonderland, these communications are encrypted, the data that is transmitted is encrypted. It's actually easy to, to create, and there are even some startups which protect USB buses from hardware attacks that protect communication between them. But unfortunately, they also don't understand how these devices work, and sometimes it's only a security by obscurity and doesn't create any new protections, any new security to protect the devices that are connected via USB bus and so on. We often heard that tampering with the cables, with the wires, is very hard and no one can do it. And you will see in the future slides that the bad guys are already there. And here's a small presentation what can do some device that is connected to the USB of the dispenser. Okay.
So here is our test bed, our ATMs lab, and here is our attacker who maybe bought key from the internet or from an insider. Attacker bypassed the first level of security, the physical level, and disconnect USB cable, USB dispenser's cable from the ATM computer and connects it to a specially crafted device. In our case, it's Raspberry Pi with a piece of code and Wi-Fi dongle and the battery. Now we can see that dispenser is in the red box and it's offline, but it still works. Attacker sent dispense comments just using their smartphone to Raspberry Pi through Wi-Fi, and Wi-Fi sent these comments to dispenser directly, and it means that bypassed all security measures which implemented on the ATM computer. So only a couple of minutes, and our attacker gets a portion of money. As you can understand, this attack might be repeated for many, many times, until ATM became empty.
OK, we spoke about USB devices and their connections. But obviously, there are operating systems that controls such devices with different software means. As Olga already mentioned, it's a Windows-based operating system. Often it's Windows XP, and we often heard from the bank that they, I think half of a year ago, some bank told us, we finally managed to move from Windows XP to Windows 7. Come on, guys, it's Windows 10 already, and you're a bit late, a bit. There are service providers that are generally represent communication with the devices in the ATM machine. They are not the drivers, they're user space, and communication is done by libUSB library. And actually, if you connect ATM, if you install on the ATM Linux operating system, all the devices will be presented as libUSB devices with their names, with what they do, and actually you can send any comment to it, as you already seen in the previous video. And these service providers are created by manufacturers. And as Olga said, it's a Lego that they combine different devices from different vendors. So there is a middleware that intercommunicates from application that actually displays information about amount of money, this creepy spam with different new credit cards and so on the ATM machine. It communicates with XFS manager. It provides it provides communication between software and the service providers. So any person can create their own software that doesn't know anything about ATM machine, but knows the interface of communication. And Windows application is just a graphical user interface. It doesn't do anything. It just gathers information from the user, from the devices, and send to processing center. But unfortunately, it's an ideal situation. In an ideal situation, they're only proxies. They don't do anything. They don't understand what is going on. They're just doing what they told from the processing center. They start secure communication, but as you have seen in the video, there is no secure communication with some devices like dispenser. I don't know why. This application has minimal interface. It doesn't provide any features, any additional technical information about the ATM machine, about the communications. But unfortunately, all ATM vendors, all banks are lazy. They don't want to spend money to create different images of operating system, different software to use only in technical means. They implement everything in one application and say, okay, we are now secure. On the right slide of the on the right hand side of the slide, you can see Tubkin that is with us for many, many years. It was based on XFS. And banks already say, okay, we know everything about malware. If we will shift from the XFS manager, from the communication, we will be 100% safe. But unfortunately, on the left-hand side, you can see another malware that intercepts communication with, from service providers that just gathers all information that are already there without any intercommunication with XFS manager. And unfortunately, in Wonderland, ATMs are secure, but in real situation, ATMs are very vulnerable because every piece of software in this slide, a Windows application system, XFS manager, service providers, can issue one command to eject money, to get the information about your credit card, to get PIN code by when the middling access to the PIN pad, and so on. And unfortunately, we have seen such cases. There are different bad guys who already attacked different banks with such target. They install sniffer like Wireshark or USB PCAP. They intercept all the data that is transmitted between host computer and card reader. They get all information about your credit card, the very same information that is used for your transaction in clear text, and send it to every server in the internet, because ATMs are generally connected to internet, and unfortunately it's a problem. And if you even go to the ATM machine, watch for different skimmers, different cameras, and so on, it won't help you, because your data is transmitted internally in the operating system to the processing center, and so on. And unfortunately, we've seen such malware that don't use general utilities. They use access to service providers. And Olga will show you an example of such a malware.
So here is our video again. This is a backdoor skimmer, which we investigated with our colleagues from Great Department several months ago. This malware activated by using special cards. Now we can see the window to enter the special password. Also, attacker can enter a number of commands, for example, to dispense money. And also, attacker can enter the number of cassette to dispense money from. One more. It was a real malware, which is widely spread around the world. And every example was targeted for various countries.
And you should understand, if you were attentive enough, that when a hacker inserted the card inside of ATM, it was returned immediately. No data was saved on the ATM host computer. It was intercepted just before the logging system even understand that something happened to the card reader. Then it intercept all the data that is inserted in the PIN pad, and there is no evidence, no nothing to investigate. And often banks won't understand how it actually happened. And unfortunately, in many cases, there's no even video surveillance to understand what they did and how it is done. Okay, but we were speaking about Windows operating system, about card reader, about USB devices. But actually, how hard to get into the ATM machine to access these interface devices, to send comments, and so on. Sometimes banks are very, very protected. There are even some ATMs inside the trucks with the policemen nearby. We often hear that in Europe it's not the case because all ATMs are through-the-wall ATMs and they're physically secure. We often hear that they are still in concrete sandwich with different protections against physical attacks. There are different alarm systems and no one can do anything in 5 minutes and get all the money. Operating systems is just a platform. It doesn't do anything. There is always protected by Windows XP with MS08067 that it can be attacked from anywhere in the network. It has robust updates, yeah, Windows XP. And different integrity controls, the last measure to protect the software on the ATM machine, to protect that there is nothing more than already on ATM. But ATMs are intercommunicated with at least processing center and ATM management system. Often it is very easy for network specialists, to connect all ATMs in the single network. Why not? They all in the same broadcast domain. They see each other, but it's completely safe. Nothing will happen. They are just sending customization data to the processing center, and nothing will happen. But unfortunately, physical access is much, much more easier than they suspect. This guy with a drill went to the ATM machine, made a hole in it, and get access to the interface cables. It's real footage. And all the money in this ATM was lost by the bank. And unfortunately, there is no alarm because no one actually opened the ATM machine. And they say, OK, no one opened, no alarm. That's fine. But in many cases, they're even lazier. We have modems near the ATM machines. We have, for example, on the left bottom side of the screen, open ATM, because, okay, the duct tape is okay. We see through the wall ATM with all the communications outside of it and easy access to the inside of the building where is ATM situated and so on. USB devices and other stuff, because opening ATM, going inside of it with the keyboard and something else, it's actually very hard to do. On the level 5, we have people, because every system is actually communicating with people, and some engineers should do different stuff with it. And when we showed you the schema of ATM, it actually was a lie, because schema is much bigger. We have different office computers, we have administrators, we have different online banking, we have a processing center, we have different databases. From the point of view of pen tester, it's a huge system that can be affected on many, many levels. For example, ordinary phishing. We have administrator accounts, and often these administrators are not trusted for managing office computers, and there is different departments, for example, for ATM machines, for office computers, and so on. And in this case, ATM administrators are often not so competent and don't know everything about their systems. As I already said, that there are different ATMs in different locations. Sometimes they are connected with 2G network because it's very cheap and very secure, because when some security specialist in bank opened the specification on the GSM network, they see, okay, there is encryption. Okay, then all communications are safe. But unfortunately, as you have seen in your mobile phones on the Congress, you see the network, the good network that you can connect with your device and send data, send calls, and so on. Actually, your connections with 2G networks can be intercepted. And what we've seen much more often, that ATMs are connected to the small network, that there are all ATMs seeing each other. There are different, there is a domain controller for these particular ATMs that can send updates to different, to all ATMs in this network. And it's not a scary thing that when you speak about a couple of ATMs and so on, but unfortunately, there are hundreds of ATMs in some banks that can be attacked with just one button, installing the group policy to install, for example, malware and disable antivirus and that. And it's often forgotten that actually ATM, it's not a box. It's often an entry point. And attacker can affect only one ATM to get the data inside of network. And for example, RP spoofing, I don't know, Olga.
And the last point from our testbed, attacker discovered some ATM network with wrong settings and got physical access to Ethernet cable. He disconnects Ethernet cable from ATM and connects Raspberry Pi again to ATM networks network. This Raspberry Pi consists of piece of code with a rogue processing center, which emulate a real one. Now all ATMs in this network are under control of attackers. And friends of this attacker can come to ATM, to all ATMs, and do something looks like original transactions, and they can use any pins, any cards, and they can change the cassette to withdraw money from, and of course they get money. And here is our jackpot. And now attacker returns to ATMs to remove this very important device and leaves no physical evidence of this attack. But please don't use this vase to get money to Chung or for other reason.
And actually, what you have seen in these videos, it's a real problem, because when we hear, okay, 5 minutes and the security guys will get to ATM with alarm system. But unfortunately, all these videos are less than 2 minutes to install the hardware, to install software, and to get to ATM and to withdraw money. It's often forgotten that, unfortunately, computers are real fast and people are not. Well, there is no conclusion from our presentation, because current security of the ATMs are like this guy. they are trying to protect some pieces of the network of ATMs. They shift from ATMs to they give their ATMs to some third party and only lease them and so on. And they hear from the internet, okay, there is Tubkin, then we'll install the antivirus on the ATMs. Okay, there are black box attacks, then we install the hardware inside of our ATMs. Okay, there are something else, and they install something else. Actually, it's a cat and mouse game, and what we shown you, it's low-hanging fruits that can be easily accessed by criminals and already accessed by criminals. And often, we don't hear about such cases because banks are very discreet about their problems, and they don't even share these problems with other banks. It's often a problem because in many countries, some bank is affected, for example, with black box attacks. It will say, we have no problems, and another bank in the same country will affect with the very same attacks, and they are not prepared for this. ATM vendors are often not so fast to implement security mechanisms, to implement their hardware to protect the banks. And often they say, we don't have a problem. We already sold you your ATM. And they don't want to invest any money into protection. And we understand them. But unfortunately, in many cases, architecture is bad. And you should feel bad about it. We know that many vendors, I think all of them, already tried to create newer versions of the ATMs with newer operating system, with newer hardware. We want to ask them, please, do it more open, not open source, do it more open to security specialists, to banks, because many times the vendor create problem, but often, very often, bank also create a problem because they don't want to implement all features that are already there. And often there are some problems can be managed with updates, with configurational options, with passwords, come on. And there is a small list, very easy to understand. If first comment or third comment return anything about your ATM machine, you're screwed. If second comment returns anything that looks like AirAdmin, TeamViewer, and other software that you don't know what is doing, you're screwed. Use Wireshark and USB pickup on the ATM machine. Just install it, press the button, intercept all the traffic, and see. Do you see the card data in the traffic? Because it's a real problem. It's not that hard to intercept USB communications. Not only with software means on the computer, but also with hardware means. For example, Beagle, the hardware to intercept data on the USB bus, costs only 500 euros, I think, or dollars, and a quarter million is in one ATM machine. What we want to see, Onion, not Tor, obviously, but Onion protection for different levels of communication. We have chain of failure with any part of the ATM infrastructure that can send one command to ATM machine and get money from it, to get that can get the card data from it, and so on. We understand that, unfortunately, security is a process, and there is always a lowest bidder who create the security in the ATMs or any other device. We know that you have different means to create money, but you always have means to lose money by allowing lowest bidder to create your security. Actually, be excellent to each other. Vendors should speak to banks. Banks should speak to vendors. Unfortunately, for the ordinary customers, we're all screwed, because software sniffer is completely indecipherable from our point of view. And if you go to ATM machine, be aware that your credit card data can be stolen with all the security measures and security mechanisms that you can do by yourself. So it's actually a problem of the bank. And if you have a problem, for example, with skimming and some transaction was get with your credit card, it's not always your problem. It's maybe a problem of the bank. We want to thank different guys, some of them here, some of them unfortunately not here, and who helped us with our research, with reverse engineering, with attacking dispenser, for example. It's a real pain in the ass. And have fun, stay safe. Thank you. Questions, maybe?
There is less signal on you. Yo, go. We got a question from the internet.
Yeah, there are, but it's not quite in here.
Yo, can you just go out quietly? Thanks.
So, first question from the internet is, you
quietly!
Said, the internet wants to know that, well, you've said there are some default open ports on the ATMs. Which ones would that be?
We don't know yet. We can't disclose this information because, unfortunately, we see the ATMs in Shodan. We see ATMs with mass scans. And this information can lead to a large amount of fraud against the ATMs, so we can't disclose that. Sorry.
Hello. So just I want to add one note. It's not always the problem of the bank itself. Sometimes it's more really the problem of the vendor of the ATM, and the part of like as you said it, it's a normal PC what's inside the ATMs, and if the bank want to now to upgrade to Windows 7 or Windows 10 or whatever, that the hardware does not support it. So you can basically change it to off-the-shelf PC, but the vendor says we will support that, or will give no warranty if you change it yourself. And they ask for just normal PC. A lot of money, and the bank, of course, will say, no, it's too much for me, and we keep it at XP.
Yes, unfortunately, we know about this situation, but we also understand that there is 10 years or 15 years or 20 years that ATM was working, and it was working fine. And banks say, okay, I want to make it secure without any additional investment. Unfortunately, it won't help. Yes, we know that there are different problems in the operating system, but there are also different problems in the software that is run on this operating system. So it's actually a very fuzzy situation, and we can't say that someone is more wrong or more right in this situation. We should all combine our expertise, our money, actually, and create much better ATMs in course of many years, maybe, but I think the sooner the better.
Thank you.
I have a question here on the right. Why do you think the ATM vendors don't invest more into Linux-based ATMs? I mean, they could do that.
Yes, they can do that, but the answer is legacy code. They already invested a large amount of money into the XFS because it's not XFS, it's Microsoft.
Extension for Financial Services.
So it's actually very tied to Windows. But we already know that some vendors already shifting from the Windows to Linux-based operating system, but and we want to see it in the, we will see it in the nearest future. So I think the situation will change.
Sometimes, maybe.
Guys, your research is amazing, and I really appreciate the work you're doing. I'd like to know, given the prevalence of, or the rise in Bitcoin ATMs and the fact that most of the software for Bitcoin, or some of the software for Bitcoin ATMs is open source, have you done any research on that, or are you planning on doing any research on that?
Unfortunately, we haven't seen these ATMs with our hands, so unfortunately, no, we haven't managed to see them. And we would like to get in touch with the Bitcoin ATMs, but unfortunately, they're so rare, and so it's not worth it, unfortunately, for now.
Thank you.
Thank you for the interesting presentation. Some of the attacks that you presented require a lot of internal knowledge. For example, the one where the attacker intrudes on the network. Where do the attackers get all this knowledge about the architecture and infrastructure?
Unfortunately, it's not that hard because they're all Windows-based, again, and general penetration test is accessing the domain controller with the highest privileges. And it's actually not the very, very different from attacking the ATM machines. And obviously, there are different engineers in the bank who have different technical information, who have different software, different test software that can be stolen. And sometimes they even share this information to the large amount of people, for example, by uploading the project on the GitHub. And you can download software from the ATM just like open source and so on.
Hello. Yes, so in terms of the ATM management systems, I would like to ask if you had a look at like FiServe and software that's like big vendors use to manage like big ATM networks. FiServe or even like a trend that some ATM networks you see in, even in Europe, they start having systems to manage the advertisements in the loading screens and so on. Did you do any sort of research on that as well?
Unfortunately, no, because there are different large systems to manage ATM machines, but there are always lazy people, lazy administrators who install additional remote control systems.
Or even devices.
And even devices, yes. So, unfortunately, no.
It's a fun area. Thank you.
Thanks again for the amazing presentation. I was wondering if you had cases where the security was better than what you presented, and especially when the serial buses communication had any encryption at all?
Yes, obviously there are different ATMs, different vendors, different banks, and we shown you extreme cases. And we can say that any ATM actually vulnerable to at least one vulnerability that we have shown you from the management system, from the network, just network without any internal knowledge, from the physical access, from the USB access, but there is no ATM that has all the vulnerabilities in it. So we have seen secure ATMs, but not very secure. Thank you.
Okay, the internet wants to know how easy would it be to get an ATM into a kind of out of service mode that is not really easy to fix. So basically, how hard is it to DOS an ATM?
With a razor or to cut the cable, it's very easy. But denial of service in ATMs, if I understood the question correctly, it's a bit out of scope of our presentation because we as the attacker, as the penetration tester, we want money from ATM, but not to disable it. Any more questions?
The internet has another question. And the internet wants to know how are ATMs specifically connected to the network, if not by 2G network, like with VPN, or what do they do? Do they like PPTP or like IPsec or something? Do you know how they do this?
Yes, we made presentations about ATM security for quite a while. I think you can see the these presentations in our Twitters. There are different possibilities, like just 2G modem, 3G modem, 4G modems, ordinary Ethernet cables. We have even seen X25 and telephone networks that are communicating with the processing center. I don't know for which purpose. Yes, there are different additional security mechanisms like VPN clients, hardware and software. For example, some device installed inside of ATM machine and connect from the ATM to a VPN client and VPN client to the outer network. But the big problem is this particular device, so for example, hardware device, you have seen in our presentation that is outside of ATM. And some hacker can disconnect the Ethernet cable and access this ATM machine. And more important, by disconnecting the Ethernet cable and connecting to the VPN client, you can connect to the network of ATM machines. So, and many of you maybe have seen ATM machines with ordinary Windows window that showed, oh, I can connect to the VPN server. So they use everything, and there is no identical ATM in different banks.
Okay. Okay. And I have one final question from the internet. And that is, would it be possible to make the ATM accept your own cassette with, like, your cache?
Maybe the question was about cache-in device that accept the banknote inside it that is not original, is not legitimate. There are such attacks. And obviously, if answering the question about the cassette, there is possibility to deal with the security guys who exchange cassettes and install, for example, cassette with just blank paper. But it's very rare, and they are easily gotten by policemen.
There is a question over there.
Yeah. Is there any different operating system installed in the ATM, Linux, for example?
Yes, there is OS2 operating system, for example, in America. There are even DOS-based. As for Linux, I haven't seen any, but I think there are.
But the most often case, it's Windows XP, still. Still alive.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you for the questions.